All right, so far, one of our major concerns about series is whether or not they converge or not. And we've been developing a number of tests in order to determine if a series converges or diverges. We're going to add to that with something called the ratio test. The image here, old-fashioned photograph of some dudes staring at each other in a mirror. And it's in reference to what the ratio test does is it compares a series to itself. And we're going to basically treat it as if it's geometric. Speaking of geometric, remember that a geometric series is going to converge if the common ratio between the terms is less than 1. It's going to diverge when that common ratio is greater than or equal to 1. And we're going to use this as a basis for the ratio test. So our series is not geometric, but we're still going to take a ratio of their terms and see if that particular ratio is getting closer and closer to some number. If it is it less than 1? We can treat it as if it's geometric, and we're going to say that it converges. Is it more than 1? If that's the case, again, geometric would say that that diverges, right? So again, this is going to be used to help us understand this new test called the ratio test. So the ratio test, it comes in 3 parts. First part of this is that we have a series of non-zero terms. And in order to set this up, I'm going to take the ratio of the n plus 1th term over the nth term. You can see I'm taking a ratio of terms. I'm taking the n plus 1th term over the nth term, take the absolute value of that, and now I'm going to take the limit. If that limit is less than 1, so I have right here a ratio of terms as I get closer and closer to infinity, if that ratio is less than 1, then if we think geometrically, our series should converge. And specifically, it converges absolutely because we threw some absolute value in there, right? On the other side of this, if we take the ratio of our terms, n plus 1th term over the nth term, take the absolute value of that, take the limit as n goes to infinity, now our ratio, it's not a common ratio, but it's a ratio of terms, it's getting closer and closer to being something bigger than 1. So think of that. I'm adding up something that's getting closer and closer to, who knows, 3. Adding up an infinite number of 3s, this thing's going to explode. It's going to diverge. If, however, I take the ratio of our terms and take the limit as n approaches infinity, I get 1. I know nothing. Our test is inconclusive. What that means is that I have to revert to some other kind of test, as we're about to see right here in this pro tip. So make sure you write something down for this ratio test. And I'm going to give you a pro tip here. When should I use the ratio test? I should use the ratio test whenever I'm working with series that have things like exponentials in it, things that have factorials, stuff that converges or diverges really quickly. It doesn't work well with P series, as we're about to see. But that's okay, because we already have a test for P series. It's really easy to use. Let's take a look at a couple of examples here. The divergent harmonic series, that's 1 over n. We know that thing already diverges, right? But if I try to perform the ratio test on it, this is what it looks like. So I'm going to take the limit of the absolute value of the n plus 1th term over the nth term, okay? N plus 1th term, I just plug in a n plus 1 in for n. I'm going to take that complex fraction and turn it into the product of the reciprocal, and it becomes n over n plus 1. I got rid of the absolute value because these are all positive numbers and the absolute value doesn't do anything to it. And if I take the limit here, I get 1, which is inconclusive. But hey, that's okay because we already know the harmonic series diverges. Let's look at a P series. A convergent P series like 1 over n squared. Here our P is equal to 2. 2 is bigger than 1, therefore this thing converges. If I tried to use the ratio test, let's see what it looks like. Limit as n goes to infinity, 1 over n plus 1 quantity squared over 1 over n squared. Again, I'm going to flip it, multiply by the reciprocal here. I can get rid of the absolute value symbols and now use a Precal rule in order to show that this limit is also equal to 1, meaning that the test fails. But it's a good thing that we already have a test for each of those, right? Okay. So let's look at an actual example that we're working through step by step. Determine the convergence or divergence of the series from n equals 1 to infinity, 2 over n factorial. This is an excellent candidate for the ratio test, because we have exponentials in here, we have factorials, you have a mixture of these, then the ratio test is the way to go. All right, probably gonna need a little bit of space for this. Good thing to have an extra page. This is, did it again, example 4? Yeah. And in example 4, we have the infinite sum n equals, I think it's 0, yeah, 2 infinity of n factorial, 2 to the n over n factorial. All right, again, I'm looking at this as a mixture of exponentials and factorials, which makes it an excellent candidate for the ratio test. And to perform the ratio test, I am going to take the limit as n goes to infinity of the absolute value of the n plus 1th term over the nth term. Anywhere there's an n, I'm going to plug in an n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial divided by the original one, which is 2 to the n over n factorial. Okay. So now what I want to do, and what is always going to happen, is that you basically turn that complex fraction into a multiplication by multiplying by the reciprocal. As a matter of fact, it's perfectly acceptable if you skip the first step and go straight to the second one. Now, are our terms already positive? I have exponentials. I'm plugging in. Well, exponential is always positive. N plus 1 factorial, that's always positive. I can get rid of the absolute value symbols, so it looks like this. 2 to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial times, and then I'm going to flip the bottom one, n factorial over 2 to the n. Now, I really think that you're going to like these because they're totally satisfying. And the reason why they're totally satisfying is because stuff cancels out so nicely. So this 2 to the n that's on the bottom here is going to cancel out with this 2 to the n and leave us with 2. The reason why that happens is because I have a division problem. 2 to the n plus 1 over 2 to the n. I have like bases, so I subtract the exponents. 2 to the n plus 1 minus n, our n's cancel, and I just get 2 to the first. Okay, you'll do it a couple of times. It'll become second nature, and you can just cross them out. All right, something similar is going to happen to our factorials. N plus 1 factorial is the same thing as n plus 1 times n factorial, and the n factorials cancel, leaving us with just n plus 1 in the bottom. All right, so that means that this limit simplifies to 2 on top is the only thing that's left, and n plus 1 on the bottom. I am ready to take this limit, and it looks pretty much like this limit is equal to 0. 0 is definitely less than 1. Therefore, we can conclude that our series absolutely converges. So we're going to say by the ratio test, our series, which was 2 to the n over n factorial, is absolutely convergent. Oh my gosh, really? Here, let me just keep going. I'm going to go back in time. Convergent is absolutely convergent. Yeah, and then I'll just kind of highlight that. Yeah. All right, that's it for this particular video. In the next one, we're just going to do a few more examples, get a hold on this ratio test and places where it does work and places where it doesn't. Mm-hmm.